So now let us do these questions. I may have covered some of these questions before, but we are going to cover them again. So if you have covered some, if you can do these questions and you can skip this part. So the first question is, design a DFA which accepts only those strings which start with 1 and end with 0 over summation is equal to 0, 1. Over summation is equal to 0, 1. So let us do the first question now. It is saying that we have to design a DFA for the strings which starts with 1 and ends with 0. That means every string, for example, if you have a string, for example, W, then it can be 1, W1, 0, such that W1 belongs to A, B star. Right. So what does it mean that every string should start with 1 and end with 0, and this W1 can be anything. The length of W1 can be 0. The length of W1 can be 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, right? So let us try to draw it. So we are going to have an initial state. This is an initial state, right? So every string should start with 1. Every string should start with 1. Then we'll go to the state B. But if a string is not starting with 1, that means if a string is starting with 0, that means this should not be accepted. We are going to reject it completely. Okay. Now after getting this one, we can have any number of ones or any number of zeros. We can have any combination of ones and zero. So what we can do is we can have any number of ones, but as soon as we get a zero, we assume that the string is going to end, and then we go to the state number C. We make it as a final state, and whatever number of zeros which we are going to get after here, then we are again going to be at the state C, because if we are getting zeros, then obviously the string is ending with zero. But if we are getting at least one, that means again we are going to go to the state B, because we assume that the string is not ending with zero. So what I mean to say here is, assume we can take some random string, some random example of strings for this case. Assume we take the string as 10, one example. We take the string as 100, another example. We take the string as 110. We can take the string as 1010. We can take the string as 1100. We can take the string as 1111. Okay, this string is not present in the language, but these strings are present in this language. You can see all of these strings are starting with 1. All these strings are starting with 1 and ending with 0, starting with 1, ending with 0, starting with 1, ending with 0, starting with 1, ending with 0, starting with 1 and ending with 0. So all the above strings should be accepted. Okay, so let us take the first string, 10. If we give 1 here, then we go from state A to state B. After reading the 0, we go from state B to state C. So it is accepted. So this first one is accepted. If you read the second one, so after reading the first one, we go from state A to state B, and from this 0, we go from state B to state C. From this 0, we are again at the state C. So this string is also accepted. If we read the third, 110, from state A to state B, from second one, from state B to state B, from this 0, state B to state C. Now, if you read this string, so it is 1010, 10, again we are getting 1 and 0. Again, after reading the complete string, we are at the state, final state. In the last case, if you read the last string, from the first string, we are going from state A to state B, and from all the subsequent strings, we are always be stuck at state B. If a string is starting with 0, for example, if you have 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, then if a string is starting with 0, then we are from state A, we are going to state C, and this string is completely rejected. So this is the DFA, which is accepting all the strings over 0, 1, which are starting with 1, and ending with 0. Okay, now let us take the second example. In the second example, they are saying design DFA with string which accepts odd number of ones, which accepts odd number of ones in any number of zeros. That means we are putting a limitation on 1 and we are not putting any kind of limitation on zeros. So take this example, odd number of ones in any number of zeros. That means what are the strings which can be present in this language? A string which is 10 can be present if it is not visible. String which is 10, it is present. Why it is present? Because number of ones are only one which is odd. String single one is present. string 010 is present in this language, string 0010 is present, string 1000 is present, and so on. That means we can have one single one or any number of zeros, any combinations of zeros and one, but the number of ones should be odd. We can also have 1110 1011, we can have 0111, we can have 1101, we can have 0001011, we can have any number of zeros and ones, right? So, but the number of ones should be odd. So here the number of ones are 1, number of ones are 3, number of ones are 5, number of ones are 7, and so on. So only odd number of ones are accepted. Now in this case, let us draw the DFA. Initially, we are at state A. And if you are at state A, that means the number of ones and number of zeros both are actually 0. Okay. Now, if we give a single 0 to this, doesn't matter because we are not counting what are the number of zeros, we are only counting the number of ones. So if we give a single 0, then we are staying at the state A. If we give a single 1, that means the number of ones are odd. So we'll go to the state B, which is a final state. Okay. Now at state B, we can have any number of zeros, because whatever number of zeros which we are going to give, we are not counting any zeros, right? So as soon as we get one more 1, we are again coming back to state A, because the number of ones are even now. What I mean to say is, for example, if you have a string which is 110, now in this case, by seeing the first one, we are moving from state A to state B. By string the second one, we are moving from state B to state A. By string the 0, we are staying at state A, and you can check the number of ones here are even. Now, the number of ones should always be even in this case. For example, number of ones should always be odd in this case to accept for the string to be accepted. For example, if you take 1111, now again you can check the number of ones there are even. That means that string should be rejected. So if you take this from state A, from the first symbol, from state A, we make a transition from state A to state B. By reading the second symbol, we make a transition from state B to state A. By reading the third symbol, we make a transition from state A to state B. By reading the fourth symbol, we make a transition from state B to state A. After reading the complete string, we are at state A, which is not a final state. Therefore, the string is rejected. So if you get any string where the number of ones are odd, you can check any combination, any random combination. For example, we have 1011101. Number of ones are odd. Now this string should be accepted. If you take any string where the number of ones are odd, doesn't matter what are the number of zeros, we will always accept it. For example, by reading the first one, we are moving from state A to state B, from 0, from state B to state B, from 1, from state B to state A, from 1, from state A to state B, from 1, from state B to state A, from the 0, state A to state A, from this 1, state A to state B. You can check it. What I mean to say is, if we are at state A, by looking the first 1, we'll make a transition to state B. By looking the next 0, we make a transition to state B to state B. By looking the third 1, we are going from state B to state A. By looking the fourth, this symbol, fourth symbol, which is 1, so we are moving from state A to state B. By looking this symbol, from state B to state A. By looking the 0, state A to state A. By looking the last 1, from state A to state B. Now after reading the complete string, we are at a final state. State B is a final state. Therefore, the string is accepted. So this is very simple. We have already done this. Now let us do the next part.